Hey guys, welcome back to Razorback Reels. I'm your host, Jordan Peden.
Michael Howell.
And our ladies,
Clarissa Bustamante
and Kristen Balls.
All right, guys, we're going to start out the show again talking about the top five at the box office right now. Number one, interestingly, Cinderella. Not too much of a surprise, so.
No. I'm excited. I liked it. And Helena Bonham Carter, I can't take her seriously. She's a stepmother, right? Because mm-hmm. mm-hmm. Her characters in Fight Club and Harry Potter are so different than like what she plays here. Like I can't see her
but
as anything
Tim
else.
Tim Burton's not in it, so it's like, why is she in it?
Yeah, she's always yeah. directing it. They're
True.
Married, right?
I saw this married, movie over the weekend, and I loved it. The animation was amazing. The costume design was amazing. And they didn't really take any creative liberties, but they added just enough background to make it really mm-hmm. interesting.
So yeah, cool. And who hasn't wanted to be Cinderella at one point in their childhood?
But I mean, they're making, like, how many remakes of Cinderella has there been? There's been, like, a Cinderella story, another Cinderella story, like.
Right.
Is it safe
but
to call it the girl's Spider-Man?
No, because it's not really like a, I don't know.
You're seeing a clip of it right now.
Yeah. But it's like a fairy tale, so maybe, I don't know if you can like do it too many times, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, I like know it's a classic, but at the same time, like, no matter how good a storyline is, it's like,
yeah, I feel
you. Everything has its due date, you know.
And surprisingly, this movie wasn't actually for the younger kids. There were some in our theater, and they fell asleep 20 minutes in. It was more kind of like a junior high and up.
Mm-hmm. Oh, perfect. Perfect, guys. I can't
and
wait.
Can
to
we
see
talk about how cute that prince is, though?
Yes.
He's from Game of Thrones. I'm a fan of him.
He's from what?
Game of Thrones.
Ooh.
Yeah.
No, he's cute. He's like.
Number two, we have Run All Night.
Another Liam Neeson movie.
I'm done with.
Yeah, I'm kind of done with. I think he just needs to stop.
Everyone's done.
He's like the Adam Sandler of like action movies. Like,
yeah.
I mean, he's just,
okay. Adam Sandler's not that bad.
He's pretty bad.
Not
Adam
comparable
Sandler,
to
Adam
Liam.
Sandler's.
If you have seen the movie Jack and Jill, your opinion might change. But this movie looks fun to me for a rental, maybe.
I don't even know if I'd spend a couple dollars or $1 at Redbox for this.
I feel really? Like all the dads that were going to go to Cinderella went to this,
went this instead.
Yeah, yeah, that's why it's never
like
true.
They send their daughters into Cinderella.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This
yeah.
one's right next sure. to it. They yeah. go, no big deal.
So yeah. it was a strategic release.
Ed Harris is in it. I like him a lot.
I
but
love him.
I don't know. Liam Neeson, I mean, he's just done the same movie for like a decade now, it feels like, so.
Well, and I think this movie would have been good if it was just like on its own or maybe if they waited a little bit, but.
Mm-hmm. Do you guys think that Liam Neeson is typecasted? He definitely
absolutely,
is.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, he's like the go-to action like
he's
hero.
He's like the badass
days.
Guy.
He can't play anything else. Like, I
Ooh,
can't
I don't
see...
know about that.
He's a good actor to play
he
stuff.
He just doesn't.
It's just, yeah, he just doesn't.
Yeah, I look, he's number two in the box office right now.
That's true.
It's successful. So
I mean,
something is working.
Well, the competition's also a little weak, too.
Well, speaking of competition, true. Number three, we have Kingsman: The Secret Service, and that looks like a cool movie.
I wanted to see that, too. It's got like a 74% on Rotten Tomatoes, so it got really good reviews, and I like spy movies. I think they're pretty cool.
It's been in the top five for a while, though, like, I think.
Yeah, it has.
I didn't expect it to hit number three. I thought maybe, you know, like, be hanging on number five.
I think last week it was like number four, wasn't it?
I think
it's
it was climbing.
Even lower. Yeah.
Yeah, it's going up, so congrats to Kingsman.
Colin
Firth.
Sweet.
Colin Firth is an amazing actor.
Yeah,
it's all him. No one else.
At number four, we have Focus.
Will Smith. He's usually a big box office person, so it's not too much of a surprise. But
and then Margot Robbie, picture. She did a really good job. Her and Will Smith are like a dynamic duo. Mm-hmm. Like I think that they look like a really good pair.
Yeah.
Or you know, like they look like a good pair and they act mm-hmm. well together. They have a good chemistry.
Yeah. Ever since The Wolf of Wall Street, I think she's kind of broken out.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's just like a really interesting plot line. So I think it just
yeah, it's like a casino, like Vegas kind of like Ocean's 11 kind of movie.
Yeah, I think number four was a good spot. Yeah. Like I think it deserved to be number four in the box office.
It might keep going too. This movie hasn't been out for very long.
Yeah. Mm.
So we might see it move up. At number five, we have Chappie. And I've heard a lot of people talk about this movie.
I love Chappie. I wish it was number one. I'm always going to be a fan of Chappie, no matter what anybody says. So I'm definitely disappointed he's number five.
Although number five is still high praise.
I mean, it's high, but it's only been out like not that long, right? Like
yeah.
you'd think it'd be higher. higher than like The Kingsman or Run All Night or something like that.
Yeah, like don't you think people would like rush to go see this rather than see Liam Neeson like go
but
on another
They have
mission?
Seen this. It was iRobot.
Yeah. Maybe it's Hugh Jackman's weird little bullet. You think it has something to do with his haircut? It's
He just loves robot movies. Like, wasn't he in like a robot movie? Like,
but he's got this weird mullet.
He does have a weird haircut. That's
and
true.
It's like,
but he was just in like Real Steel, whatever it was called.
Yeah, Real Steel.
Like a few years ago, where it was like another
Smash
robot.
And bash.
Yeah, like another like robot like kind of movie. So
I don't know. Yeah. This movie I guess just doesn't really that. Interest me that much.
Yeah.
I'll watch it with my dad. I'm sure.
That's a good plan.
All right, guys, we're gonna take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back.
Doesn't mean. No one else is gonna die because of you.
You know, I'm just one person. I'm not worth it.
No, you are worth it. You are worth it to me. You have to promise me that you're not gonna leave. But I want you to promise me that you won't go.
And I know you won't tell what I said. Cause two can keep a secret if one of them is dead.
Hey guys, welcome back to Razorback Reels. Now we're going to take a look at movies that are coming up and give you our professional opinion on them. And we're going to start with Zoolander 2. So I want to know everyone's thoughts, and I want to know how you felt about the first one. Should there even be a sequel?
Yes, absolutely. I'm a huge fan. I mean, I love Chappie, but Zoolander is amazing. I loved it so much. Do you not feel the same way, Michael?
I like Zoolander, but I don't want it like a sequel. Like,
why?
You know how Dumb and Dumber was really good?
Yeah.
And then two was
just terrible. I feel like it's going to be kind of this. I mean, plus they're kind of old for their roles.
I mean, but you don't know until you try, right? I mean, like, it could
know,
be really
though,
bad, but
I mean,
it could be really good.
I think it could almost be more hilarious since they're older and they're still trying to model.
True.
Oh,
that's interesting. Yeah. That's good. Yeah. I think it was really funny because the characters of Derek Zoolander and Hansel closed the Valentino fashion show. Like, they were actually.
That was like the promotion to, like.
It was amazing.
Yeah, it was cool.
I cannot believe that Valentino let them do that. But
guys, this is Ben Stiller too.
Oh my goodness!
I mean,
goodness.
The guy
Look
is
at him.
Brilliant.
He's great.
He's
wow.
Now, I'm gonna tell you the number one reason I'm looking forward to this movie. When this movie first came out, a friend of mine and I went as Zoolander and Hansel for Halloween.
Wait,
and
you were Hansel.
After
right?
this release, I'm going to have to do that again.
I mean,
yeah, why not?
I was Hansel.
I'll be Zoolander and Hansel. Like,
yeah.
I'm okay with it. Like,
yeah,
we could do that.
You
do you want to do
why
that
not?
For Halloween?
Hey, look at that.
There you go.
Oh, so they're so good. Look
this
at
movie,
that. Don't you want to see that again? Like, don't you want to see that? Like, I'd be okay with that going on in series, honestly.
I need some more Blue Steel in my life.
Everyone needs a little bit more Blue Steel in their life.
And I think Ben Stiller and that girl, I don't remember her name in the movie. I think that they're married in real life.
Oh, I know you're talking about. She played the female interest in the first Anchorman.
Yes.
Christina Applegate.
No. Not Christina Applegate. It's a different
No, it was the female interest in Dodgeball.
She was in Dodgeball with Ben Stiller.
Yep, that's right.
Yeah.
They look the same. They look really similar.
Oh, yeah.
They look completely different.
Christina Applegate.
They kind of look
Oh,
like,
them. I
no,
thought
the
you
two
Ben Stiller
the two
and
one.
His wife.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no, obviously they don't look the same.
Yeah, so I think that they're in a lot of stuff together. That's really cool.
Absolutely,
yeah.
Zoolander 2, it looks like. Is getting a positive vote in most cases.
Yeah.
No.
Mm-hmm. Michael, just stop.
I'm gonna hold out.
It's gonna be
He's
okay.
holding out. 3 out of 4, guys. Next, we have Beauty and the Beast. And Ryan Gosling turned down this role, which is gonna be a disappointment to Clarissa. So we're gonna turn over to her and ask
okay.
her how she feels.
I'm definitely disappointed that Ryan Gosling isn't playing because, I mean, who doesn't love Ryan Gosling? I mean, ask any girl there in love with him.
I do.
But Dan Stevens is playing instead, which, I mean, he's pretty cute too. I mean, he's got that, he's got that dirty blonde hair and those bright blue eyes.
The analysis is just...
So,
awesome.
I mean, he looks, did you see a picture of him? He
yes.
looks just like Ryan Gosling. Mm-hmm. He's literally a lookalike, but I don't know, like, how good
it's
he is at
weird.
Acting, but...
Yeah.
But I'm excited about Emma Thompson as Mrs. Potts. I loved her in Saving Mr. Banks, so I can't wait to see what she can do in this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't really know much about Beauty and the Beast. and I don't really know much about Dan Stevens, but I know Rob Schneider would have been
an excellent candidate
for that role.
Yeah, I have to agree.
Well, Dan Stevens was from Downton Abbey. If anybody watched that, if you know who
okay.
that is.
All right.
Well, now my mom might like it. But do you guys think it's going to be kind of a weird transition? Because everyone is familiar with this movie as being animated, mm-hmm. and now it's going to be this.
Well, Cinderella was animated before, right?
Yeah,
I mean, they can
Cinderella.
Definitely do it. Like, it won't be that much of a jump, I don't think.
Yeah, and there was that movie Beastly.
Yeah.
And that was sort of a similar thing.
And then Maleficent.
Yeah, Maleficent was amazing. Mm-hmm. That was a really good movie. So I think if they do it right, then it should be fine. Mm-hmm. But yeah. I mean, there's a lot of things that could go wrong when you're going from animated to like real life. But if you have like the right actors, I mean, is it Emma Watson playing Belle?
She's the female lead.
Yeah. So I mean. Whatever she's in, I think she's going to do good. Like, she mm-hmm. can't fail, I don't
yeah.
think.
Yeah, and we have, this movie has a star-studded cast. Kevin Kline is playing Belle's father. He's mm-hmm. fantastic. Luke Evans is playing Gaston.
Gaston? Mm.
So, that should be fun.
Yeah.
Next we have, this is for the One Tree Hill fans. Michael.
Definitely.
Michael.
Absolutely, let's get to it.
Creator Mark Schwann does it again with a new show, The Royals. Is anyone familiar with this show?
I mean, I looked at it and I like read a little bit about it, and it had a 6.8 on IMDb, so it's rated pretty high. But honestly, I'm just tired of all these shows that are just about like sex, drugs, and betrayal. Like, it's
that's
just
like every show though, right?
It's like another reality show, except like scripted. Like, it just seems like a little trashy.
Yeah, I saw this episode and I don't know that I would really compare it to One Tree Hill, truthfully, but I also kind of feel like maybe it's one of those shows that just takes you a little bit to like really get into it. Mm-hmm. I liked it, but it was kind of a little bit overdone, a little bit cheesy. I don't know if I would necessarily watch the whole season or not.
Yeah,
it must be successful. I mean, people must like it if it's nominated for another season already.
True,
but a 6.8 is not very high.
I mean, that's more than a 5.
It is more than a five.
It is more than a
five, that's true.
But I mean, just like watching like that little like preview, there was like already like 3 sex scenes in it. So like, if that tells you about like what it's going to be about, then I don't know if that's something that you'd want to watch.
And truthfully, what pilots start out amazing anyway.
True.
Yeah.
So Do you guys think that this show will see the same sort of success that One Tree Hill saw?
No.
Probably not. One Tree Hill's got a huge like fan base. I don't think it's going to reach that kind of level. But
yeah.
Agreed.
Yep.
Guys, let's quickly talk about Gotham. It's setting records for being the most watched show this year.
I find that hard to believe, though. I don't know. I can't believe that.
Why? You're not a Batman dude?
Well, compared to all the other shows out there, like Game of Thrones, Mad Men, anything else that's really good that comes to mind? I don't know. It just feels like, I feel like Gotham kind of like got lost in the shuffle, but.
Yes.
I
mean, what's
he's lying to you. He dresses up as Batman almost every day. And walks around the house in a cape, so. Yeah.
But about Gotham, it's a prequel to Batman. So here you see Batman, like he's 14 years old. So then you kind of know like where things start and like mm-hmm. how things unfold. So, I mean, it's just kind of annoying because if they don't do a sequel, then they do a prequel. Like, I feel like there's a lot of prequels. And like with Batman, like, I'm not that interested, like, where
Batman's
he came
definitely
from.
Been overdone.
Is it
sure.
because yeah. a cute yeah. dude is hidden behind a mask?
Nope.
That's like, not Clarissa's
it's
thing.
It's not.
Take the mask off.
And with Jada Pinkett Smith leaving, no. I mean, she makes the show. Every time she's in a plot line, I just felt like it was more interesting, and she's really evil and conniving.
I met her once, and she's just a fantastic woman.
Wait, is she the daughter of Will Smith?
No, she's his wife.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, she
signed
just,
my tennis
she
shoes.
She likes Fish Mini.
Is she a better actor than her son?
Oh, yeah. But her son's young.
Probably.
He's pretty bad in The Karate Kid.
Yeah, he's awful.
And Jada Pinkett Smith's character wasn't in the comic books, so it's just in the TV show, which is interesting that people still think it's a good character, because a lot mm-hmm. of people get upset when, you know, TV shows add another character, add like another plot line, but in this case, it's working really well.
Yeah,
that's cool.
I think it's because it's played by her. That's the only
thing. Yeah, I mean, I think if
she's
they had
a power character.
Yeah, if they had like a random person, then that wouldn't work.
Mm-hmm. Guys. There's a movie taking over social media right now, and it's ironically called Unfriended. So I want to know what you guys think about this. It's been super popular online.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like really interesting. Like at first, I thought it was kind of like a PSA about like, watch what you post on social media, because it starts like, it's like this girl who gets like an embarrassing like drunk video posted of her like on the internet. But after you watch it for a little bit, it's just weird. It's a horror movie.
I feel like it's gonna be hard to take this movie seriously though, because like the entire movie is like them in a Skype call.
And okay, we all participate, and this doesn't happen to any of us, so it just seems highly unrealistic to me.
Well, I think it's like they have to stay on the Skype call, because if they leave, then they like, die. Yeah.
So you're just watching people on Skype?
Yep, basically. Yeah. I'm sorry, that doesn't interest you.
It's like the scary social network.
Yeah.
If they leave or stop talking, then one of them's going to die, because they're trying to figure out who posted this movie. Because a girl that killed herself was the most popular girl in school. And
absolutely.
And this other group of kids, they weren't. And so that's why they tortured her so much, and she killed herself.
Yeah, because she had that, someone put that video of her online, and she got bullied and teased about it, and so then she killed herself, and then,
that's
like,
sad.
Yeah, absolutely. And, like, in the movie, it was just really weird, because she's like, okay, like, if someone doesn't tell me in, like, 10 minutes, like, one of you guys is gonna, like, have something bad. And it was really gross, but in the trailer there was like a kid and he had his like hand in the blender and
blood
everywhere.
The trailer alone just gave me nightmares. I'm not gonna see this movie.
Is it like supernatural though? Like, is it like a ghost haunting? I couldn't figure that
out.
Yeah,
it's like her. It's like her on Skype. Like she's like typing and
so
like,
she's like
that
so
video
she's like not dead.
Well, she is dead, but they don't know. It's under her name, and it's like this seventh person just randomly kind of enters their
it
chat
It could be like
room.
Pretty Little Liars when there's
yeah,
like A.
Exactly. It's
who's
like
Allison
like
is dead, okay. But like A is like still doing stuff, so I don't
exactly.
know.
Exactly.
Well, that sounds weird.
Yeah, I'm absolutely. Not into it.
But lastly, in this segment, we're going to talk about American Horror Story Hotel. Matt Bomer, Cheyenne Jackson, joining Lady Gaga as season regulars. So.
I still think it's so weird that Lady Gaga is in this. Like,
it is really weird.
I mean, she fits in really well. Like, watching her music videos and the things she wears to award shows and whatnot. Like, she would wear those costumes out in the public anyway. But she looks good. Like, I think she's doing really well.
Matt Bomer is on one of my favorite shows, White Collar, and he's a really good actor. So, I mean, that's a good pickup for that cast.
Yeah, absolutely. And well, they had to compensate because it looks like the show is losing an important person. Jessica Lange is not returning.
Mm-hmm.
She's the face of American Horror Story.
Right.
Really? I think this is going to change the whole dynamic. And plus, they're adding in all these people, especially Lady Gaga. I feel like she's going to steal the show a little bit.
I mean, there's like our like the way American Horror Story works. Like, there's like a strong like setting, like a strong way everything works. So I feel like even if they do lose like a main character like that and bring more in, it's still gonna be like this good cinematography, this really creepy, scary stuff. So I think people are still gonna watch it.
True.
Like, it might lose like a little bit of its fan base, but I think like most of it's still gonna be there.
Look, yeah, she's right. There's nothing that you could do to make me not watch this show, all right? American Horror Story is my life.
Good, so. I'm glad.
Okay, we're gonna end this portion of the show with a clip from the new movie, Insurgent. So enjoy, and we'll see you soon.
Jeannie's never gonna stop searching for you. Why? What does she want with her?
Tell me.
Look, all I know is she's exactly what Jeannie needs. She's the perfect subject.
You're responsible for the death of hundreds of people. You know the punishment for that.
Listen. I found a way to live with the blood on my hands. And can you?
Then I know you won't tell what I said. Cause two can keep a secret if one of them is dead.
Hey guys, welcome back to the show. I just want to reemphasize, you gotta really be careful to avoid the freshman 15, okay? You just saw that commercial, but we all feel so passionately about it. You know, you're healthy. But we have a few announcements here. Spring break is next week for those of you who didn't know that.
So if you have the freshman 15, then it's time to start that workout.
It's a good time to just get back into the habit of healthy eating and a healthy lifestyle. But we're not going to be doing Razorback Reels next week. So I was looking at the wrong camera. There will be no show next week. But, you know, if you miss us over the break, you can follow us on Twitter. And Clarissa over here could probably speak more about that.
I mean, we have a Twitter, and it's called Razorback Reels. And we'll tweet about the different, like, TV shows and movies that's coming on, and just, you know, what we're doing. Maybe snap some pics of the cast on spring break.
Ooh. From what we've seen, it's always great pictures of us.
Yeah, it's great,
it's great pictures of us.
Sleeping and crying. Yeah. All right, guys, let's talk about what's coming soon.
Sure.
Kumiku.
Good. I think that's exactly how you say it.
Let me try that one more time.
No, you're right. That's it.
I took Japanese for 2 years, so I'm highly embarrassed.
Did you really?
Kumiko, the treasure hunter. So the trailer says stunning. That's exactly what I think.
I don't feel the same way.
No?
You think it looks good?
I don't think it looks all that stunning, but
guys, let's just not even talk about this one. It sucks.
Yeah.
How about do you believe? Do you guys believe?
No. Well, yeah. Wait. Let me rephrase that. That was like my go-to answer, but then after I realized like what this movie was about, I realized that wasn't the right answer. Yeah. I think it's kind of like one of those movies. It's just like like
Morgan
God
Freeman?
Is not dead. If y'all ever watched that movie,
Morgan Freeman in this movie?
I don't know. I thought it was a Justin Bieber thing.
Oh.
And it follows 12 different lives and 12 different stories, which I think is really interesting. And Alexa Vega's in it from Spy Kids.
Oh,
I'm excited to see her in it.
Yeah.
Guys.
What?
What about the gunman?
Yeah.
I don't really.
I mean, it's from the director of Taken, Sean Penn. Just kind of another action movie. I mean, a good one, but
Sean Penn's good, but
I really like him.
I don't know.
I don't know. It doesn't look like that good of a movie. It looks okay, but not something that I would really spend a lot of time on.
Yeah.
Guys, just I'm going to mention this movie quickly because it has sort of a weird appearance in it, but Zombievers, that's their actual name. It's featuring John Mayer for a short segment.
So. Is he
like a 2-minute cameo.
It's a quick little thing.
Yeah.
Zombie Beavers, that's what it is. I'm not sure why they would make that, but
I think it's going to be like a horror, like comedy kind of movie. Oh, so maybe it'll be funny.
How can it be horror and comedy, like Zombie Beavers?
Are they cute?
They are not cute. They look really weird.
Are they cute?
Hey, cute
they
is relative.
No, they're
like
so weird.
I need to know which one.
And they have
they're
beady
cute.
Eyes.
Yeah, they're cute.
They have really beady eyes.
He's not. I think you're wrong.
Hey guys, let's quickly talk about Tracers because it's got Taylor Lautner.
Well, that's an automatic no for me.
I don't know.
What did you say, Michael?
That's an automatic no.
Oh,
Tracers.
Because Taylor Lautner.
Let's ask Clarissa how she feels about it.
He is awful.
I like Taylor Lautner. That's all I have to say.
Is he the guy from Twilight?
He's the wolf.
So like he's the guy that never has his face in any picture, but it's like his abs.
Yes.
Like his abs are his face.
Yeah.
Honestly, he did a really good job in Twilight because like
he's got big abs.
Okay.
Just the whole role.
He's got big abs and like.
No, that's not why. It's just because like he looks the part.
They're big and smooth.
But I think that he's not that great of an actor, so I'm not sure how he's gonna do in this movie. So we'll see how that works out.
I'm not really that.
He's pretty awful.
All right, guys. Well, we're going to end the show today with a quick reminder that if you want to participate in this show in any way or you want to voice your opinion or thoughts or anything you want to say that's not hateful, unless it's about Michael, you can reach us at our phone number and you can also reach us by our Skype name, which should appear at the bottom of our screen online. So if you'd like to.
So people are going to Skype in now?
I guess.
So we're going to turn to that movie.
We're going to turn words.
Stop. Oh.
If you're the dead guy in that movie, don't call. Please.
Please.
No. All right, guys. We're going to end the show today with a trailer of Insurgent. We'll see you not next time.
You found it. The future our people deserve.
What does Janine think is in that box, Caleb?
I don't know, but she's testing Divergence. Searching for the one who can open it.
Find them. Every last one of them.
Janine's never gonna stop coming after us. It's time we fight back.
We don't have the numbers.
We will.
This is factionless? This is insane.
Janine claims you're all dangerous insurgents. If we were to combine forces, we'd be unstoppable.
Stop! I can't let anyone else die because of me.
Chris, help me!
It's really good to see you again.
What does she want with her?
It's the perfect subject.
Be strong. Be brave. She's the one.
This is the only chance we have to rescue what little civilization we have left.
Dark times call for extreme measures. Let's begin.
I'm not gonna fight you.
Of course you're not. You're gonna fight you.